Good afternoon. This is Laqueen Battle from Battle First Aid Responder Services coming right here from the Staples Connection Desk here in Staples, Massachusetts. I want to go ahead and review a couple things and go ahead and give you a shout out. Again, my name is Laqueen Battle. I'm president and founder of Battle First Aid Responder Services coming right here from Boston, Massachusetts. I am director and owner of the nonprofit, the community health nonprofit, First Aid Nonprofit, First Aid Responder Services, as well as I provide emergency medical and public safety events here and trainings. I'm getting in the midst right now of doing trainings here in the Boston area. So again, I will let you know, my name is Laqueen Battle. I'm also a published author too, as well. And just shout out to you. Again, please guys, continue to get tested for COVID-19, as well as the vaccine is soon due to roll out. So please be sure to go out there and get vaccinated. Right now, the main priority is given to people who are over 65 and also to our first responders. So I want to go ahead and give a shout out to all the first responders and everybody pretty much who's involved in COVID-19 work. Okay. A couple of things I haven't faced myself, but I'm going to stay because it's a public space. A couple of things I want to get over a journey very quickly is, again, today is the second week of January. I do have some events that I'm going to be doing. I'll post this on my Facebook events page, as well as I will post them on my Eventbrite. So we'll let you guys know what is going on with my nonprofit. There's a lot of events going on. I'm actively involved with my nonprofit. I'm trying to work right now with this, with Boston Logan International Airport, with some safety issues there, some concerns there, as well as with Encore Casino, some safety concerns there. And I know there's some other things that need to be addressed and adjourned with some embassies here, some consulates and embassies here in the Boston area. So thank you to the Staples that was open today here in downtown Boston. I really do appreciate that. Okay. All right. So, I want to go ahead and encourage you guys to please get tested for COVID-19. Please get tested. Also, this is the Massachusetts travel form right here, or the travel form for COVID-19. It says effective August 1st, all travelers must have this traveler form in order to comply with COVID-19 standards for Massachusetts. So it's a travel form you get at the airport, you get at the Department of Health. Pretty much you get this anywhere in general, as well as there's a more general form at the Greyhound, and as well as at the Amtrak stations. You get it. It's called the Massachusetts Travel Form. You get it right here. So pretty much general, what you do is you get this form right here, and you scan this form. You get this form right here, and then you scan it. Take the QR scan code right here, and you scan it. The scan code comes up right here, and then it goes open mask in Safari, and then that's how that works. It opens up this file right here, which is called the Massachusetts Travelers Form right there. Okay, it's called the Massachusetts Travel Form. Okay. Which it comes from this form right here. Okay, they're the same form. This is the Massachusetts travel form. Okay. So bear with me in mind, guys, okay? Again, I'm working on some more publications, I'm working on another book, some more reports, and to continue to what I did this past summer at Harvard University, as well as continuing some more publications in the events, post it to the events, let the public know what I did, the president's debates. I'm doing some more publications with that. I'll be doing some work, and as well as working with the public, figure out what's going on with that. So I'm very much happy, concerned about that, being involved in this city, as well as doing what I can for COVID research, COVID-19 research, being out there, letting people know, even if it's a 3-page report, or a 5-page report, or a 100-page report, whatever it is, just letting people know what's going on here in the Boston area, as well as in New York, Salt Lake City, Nashville, all over, letting people know exactly what I did for COVID-19 research, okay? Alright, so here's what we're going to do. I have a couple events. Again, I have a couple events. This week, I'm going to be meeting with Boston City Hall, talking about what's going on with climate planning with Boston City Hall, as well as the inauguration is next Wednesday of President Joe Biden, Kamala Harris, our first female vice president. So again, I encourage you guys to go out here, try to meet with some church groups who are going, looking for some donations, and out there, be involved, do what I can, be involved. So I'm trying to learn how to set up my QR code. I've got these QR codes, and these square readers right here, and as well as on my Cash App and Venmo, these square readers. Here's an Android one. I got the Apple one, and then I've also got one for Android here. I've got the Apple and I've got the Android. They will both show me how to get donations and do what I can. Okay. All right. I'm meeting with Boston City Hall this Thursday, okay? It's going to be this Thursday at 1 o'clock in Boston City Hall. I'll try to follow up later there on one of the events. I'm also spoke to my insurance company about getting some more claims for the workers' comp, as well as filing some more claims. Like I said before, my nonprofit has serviced literally over 100,000 people, so there should be some way I can get compensated for that, as well as other nonprofits who do the same thing I do. They are still able to get compensated for their services too. Okay. So I'm meeting with Boston City Hall this week. Have a couple personal doctor's appointments. Have a job interview on Wednesday. Hey, and then the inauguration is next Wednesday in Washington D.C. So I'm trying to get tickets for that. I might have to cancel that doctor's appointment. And then I'm also filling out an application for a grant, a nonprofit grant here in Boston. It's called the TBF Foundation. And their applications, there's over 20 grants for nonprofits here in the Boston area. So they have grants. I'd be able to help them and other people like myself who have nonprofits. So I'll be able to get out there and do what I can. So please try. And in my heart, extremely hot mess. And then I've got to constantly get out here, and I have this tablet, this phone book. Get out here, do what I can. I'm in receiving my phone calls, so I am taking messages. I am taking messages. I am taking messages. Okay. And then I am, if you guys give me your card, I will go ahead and follow up with you. Just give me your card. I will email you and let you guys know who I am and where I need to be. And guys, help you follow up with that too. Okay. And then my Google list, I will go ahead and get that out to a couple people here in the Boston area. Let them know, hey, this is LaQueen. This is what I do. Become involved in me and my process and get things going. That's how I'm going to do this. Let's go for it right now. So anyway, I've got a lot of things to do. The main thing I have done, so I do send out my daily emails today. I'm kind of behind my emails, so I'm trying to get started again. It is Monday, January the 11th. So again, I'm trying to get that back step focused, getting my emails in focus, getting these donation letters. Let people know, hey, the Queen needs donations. Hey, I need another office. Hey, I need medical staff. Hey, I'm also trying to set up therapy sessions, so I'm going to try to offer peer support as well. Check out my YouTube channel. I'm trying to sell some more. I'm trying to sell some books. I'm reaching out to bookstore sellers to put my books out in publication. Hey, so I'm an author. I'm a published author. I'm applying to graduate school. I'm applying to medical school. I'm applying to nursing school. So I need to be studying. I need to be reading. I need to be studying. So there's a lot of things coming into motion for myself, LaQueen, Arlene Battle, as well as other people that have given me support over the years. I really am very much thankful for everybody who has given the support this year. Very, very much thankful for that. Other than that, this is McQueen Battle. I'm currently living in the Boston area, relocating here in Boston, back and forth between New York and Boston. So I usually go to downtown Manhattan, or I go to upstate New York and Albany. Further as I go to Syracuse, that's it, and Buffalo. But I just go back and forth between Manhattan and Boston, maybe Brooklyn if there's an event. I will be starting to do some book tours, so I will be in the motion right now. Okay, I got a lot to do. I'm a hot mess right now. I'm a hot mess because, number one, I don't have any funding, okay, except my own personal expenses. And number two, I'm a college graduate. At the same time, I'm applying for graduate school, applying for housing. I'm looking at housing. And also, I don't have any friends or fellow people in the city to talk to, so it's just me by myself. I'm doing everything by myself. I have some people here that are ready to talk to, so pretty much I'm here because of COVID. I'm glad COVID is actually, the second phase has come a little bit more down, so I'll be coming published. Yeah, there, some bookstores are closing down, but they're trying to do what they can, okay? So, my main goals this week are, of course, to fill up my doctor's appointments, try to get one of my books, some books into print, okay? So that is another one of my goals, is to get my books. They're on ebook, okay? They're available on ebook, but I need to get them into print. I got over 10 books published, okay, on Amazon, Kindle, and on BarnesandNobles.com, but they need to be in print. So I need to take them over from ebook to print, okay? So I got over 10 books published. You guys can get what I'm saying. I need to be into print. I need an ISBN number. I need a print number. And also, they need to be into print. So they need to be into print. So that's the number one goal, is to get my books into print. The second goal I have right here is, of course, to ask about personal doctor's appointments. The interview with City Hall. If you would like to join me, if you're here in the Boston area, and you're one of my supporters on Facebook, on YouTube, and you would like to support me, if you want to come to Boston City Hall and join me with my interview, with my appointment this week with Boston City Hall, come and support me. I would really, really appreciate that with Boston City Hall. I would really, really, really appreciate that. I would really honestly appreciate that. And some people say, whatever I do in my business, I'm a single black woman, and it's kind of work where it's predominantly male-dominated construction business owners that do what I do, okay? It's mainly security guards and construction owners that do what I do, because that's usually who I deal with every single day. That's pretty much who I deal with in this business, is construction. It's just all construction crews and security guards. It's pretty much 50 to 80% of my working crew right now, okay, is construction and security guards. They're like, we don't want your business, we don't need your business. Well, you still do, and I'm still here. That's how it works, okay? Right now, the economy's not doing bad, but the cities, all of that, they still need help. They're still rebuilding their brand out here, okay? It needs to work. We need to make this happen, and we need to make this work, okay? So, I need to file a claim, as well as get more medical supplies for DC. Hopefully it won't be as big, huge. It's gonna be a whole bunch of people there. So what I'll do is I'll just have my pack. They won't be checking bags or anything like that, but I'm available for services either outside the venue or in the parks. I'm available for services. I won't overdo myself like I did usually last time at the National March in Washington. So this week, I do need to be calling some officials in Washington, D.C., let them know, hey, McQueen Battle wants to be able to provide first aid services at the D.C. inauguration. What do I need to do? McQueen Battle wants to help you guys. What do you want me to do? Okay? Which is usually how it works, how it happens. And they're like, oh, you're fine. Don't worry about it. We got it out of control. Well, you know what? Hey, guys, I bring my pack. I bring my scrubs. I'm here to help you guys out. That's usually how it works for me. Because I bring my whole tent and it doesn't work that way. You can do it like that. Okay. So anyway, I'm going to get my books into print. That's number one. Number two is I've got to call some people in D.C. and Washington, D.C. in order, like I told you before in the last video, in order to process what they need as well as what I need. And I already know right now that the inauguration team and Joe Biden and Kamala Harris' inauguration team is already working that into motion. So I'm very, very happy about that. So great that I'm receiving emails from the inaugural team at NBC. So if they are available, they can reach me, Looking Battle here in Boston, and LaQueenAtBattle@gmail.com. And I do know that people go back and forth between D.C. every single day here in Boston every single day or every couple days. This is how it is. Okay, I wish I could do that same, but I'm not that fluent yet. Okay. So I need to call D.C. for just for information. Okay. And then another thing I need to do, of course, is to talk to some people. One of my girlfriends I met yesterday, she's so nice, she told me that people will actually donate their COVID-19 testing kits. I'm like, are you serious? And she's like, yes. People will actually donate their COVID-19 testing kits to people that need them, to nonprofits like myself, as well as medical personnel who need extra COVID-19 testing kits. So I'm like, that is so awesome. I will take that as well. So I need to be asking some people for donations of COVID-19 testing kits. That is something else that I need to do. Donations for COVID-19 testing kits. And that's also another profit margin that you could do as well. Okay, so anyway, it's a couple things I've got to do. Today's Monday, it's January the 11th, it's the 2nd of January. There's a lot of things to do, and as well as the process to motion. I'm here at the Staples Studio. I would love to work with the studio with the TV stations. I would love to work with Boston Globe. I would love to be at City Hall. I would love to be at the State House, the Capitol. I would love to be in D.C. I would love to be in Manhattan. I would love to be in Albany. I would love to be in Chicago, in Springfield, whatever it is, God willing. But you got to take things one day at a time, okay? You got to take things one day at a time. Please continue to get tested for COVID-19, okay, for you and your family and loved ones, as well as be sure to check up on the information about what was going on with the vaccine. The vaccine is in its development phase because it's the second strain of COVID, okay? So what you can do right now is you can check on your local health department for your city and your state, Google it, health department for my city and my state, what's going on with the COVID-19 vaccine rollout, as well as the main priority right now is given to seniors, those with disabilities, and first responders, police, medical personnel who are working every single day with COVID-19 individuals. Okay, those people who already have a 9-to-5 schedule. They're the ones we're giving access. So if you have a 9-to-5 schedule right now in the medical field and you're a police officer, you get priority for the vaccine already. That's already in the works, okay? And then also, as well as another issue that I want to talk to you guys about is suicide. Suicide is a really big issue. Please do not take that to heart. It is a really big issue. There are people all over the world that are struggling right now with depression. They're getting rid of their houses. They're losing their mortgages. They're losing their jobs. Whatever it is, whatever you're going through, please just take it one day at a time. Talk to somebody about the issues that you're going through. Talk to somebody about the struggles that you're going through. It's not easy. It doesn't happen overnight. But at the same time, though, you cannot do things by yourself. Okay? You cannot do things by So, we want to make sure, oh God, Rachel, right? We want to make sure, as well as myself, being a medical professional, I'm studying nursing right now, and I'm studying community and emergency health, that if you are suicidal, or if you had any intentions of hurting yourself or others, please talk to somebody. Go out there and get help. Call 911 or go to the emergency, the nearest safe haven, so that you can talk to somebody about your feelings. You can tell somebody what you're going through, okay? If you feel that you're a danger to yourself or to others, please get help. Do not wait. Please, please get help, okay? All right. So this is LaQueen Battle, published author, COVID-19 researcher. And I mean, hey, it's a lot to do. I do more with the sociology part of COVID. If you want to get into the biology and the microbiology and chemistry behind it, that's a little bit more detail. That's where that money is at. But I deal with the easy aspect of the sociology, how it deals with people. I'll be doing some more of surveys and things like that, of course. But you gotta take things one day at a time. And I can only do it by myself. Okay. All right, so this is a clean bottle. Currently here in the Boston area, president, founder, author, Battle First Aid Responder Services, certified medical assistant, certified first aid, CPR, adult pediatric, and EMS AED. And I will currently take classes right now in emergency preparedness and public health for the state of Massachusetts right now. I'm currently getting a certificate, taking a certificate class for emergency preparedness and public safety right now. So, guys, keep me your thoughts and prayers. I need help just as much as you need help me go out there and make things work together, okay? I cannot do it by myself, and neither can you. Need to work together, all right? This is LaQueen, president, founder of Battle First Aid Responder Services. I love you guys. Keep me your thoughts and prayers. If you do need to reach me, please send donations to Battle First Aid Responder Services on Cash App and Venmo, as well as Santander Bank. And also, you can email me 24 hours a day, 7 days a week at battlefirstaid@icloud.com or laqueen.battle@gmail.com. Battle First Aid, BATTLE, the number 1, STAID at icloud.com. Okay, I love you guys. Keep your thoughts and prayers. I'm a hot mess. I'm right here next to beautiful City Hall. It's beautiful. The mayor of Boston, Marty Walsh, is going to give his briefing tomorrow. So that's awesome. That's great. I'm glad here. I'm done for the day. I'm going to get a burger. I'm going to get some eat. I got more of these to distribute. Okay. So it is what it is. I got to go out of the explanations. I got to get a bus ticket to D.C. I'm a hot mess. LaQueen is a hot mess. But I do what I can. All right. Please, guys, continue to keep me in your thoughts and prayers. Again, if you need to reach me, you can email me at laqueen.battle@gmail.com as well as battlefirstaid@icloud.com. All right? I love you guys. Please continue to keep me in your thoughts and prayers. You gotta take things one day at a time. Literally. And please continue to wear your face mask. It's very, very important that you wear your face mask. You've got to take things one day at a time. It won't happen overnight, but just take things one day at a time. Okay, let's take it one day at a time. Alright, guys, continue keeping your thoughts and prayers. I cannot do this without you, and we cannot work together by ourselves. Okay, we'll do this together, okay? I will continue to pray for me. If you need to reach me, contact me 24 hours a day at battlefirstaid@icloud.com as well as laqueen.battle@gmail.com. I love you guys. Keep me awesome.